Hi, this is Tammy Powley. You can find me at my weblog, Crafty Princess Diaries, at www.tammypowley.com. Stop by, read about my adventures in the crafting world, and please sign up for my newsletter. In this video, I'm discussing the different sizes of yarn and usually what they're used for, starting from thick yarn like the bulky, moving down from worsted, DK, fingering, and all the way back down here to thread. Thread is a little bit different. I'm including it because I like to use it to make jewelry, and hopefully I'll have some videos on that in the near future, as well as some projects up on my website. But I'm including it because it really is used very often to make things like doilies. You've probably seen that before. But also making jewelry with beads, and this thread is very popular lately. You can pick this thread up just about any place. You can usually pick up yarn, and the sizes I'm showing you here, this is a 10, and so is this. This is cotton. Sometimes you can also find this in silk if you want to get fancy. So that's an example of what you might find. You can see it's on like a hard ball here. There's a piece of cardboard in here because this stuff here, you could barely see it. It's quite thin. Okay, so moving on. Here is a little bit thicker. You can see it's quite a bit thicker. This is sock yarn. It's also sometimes referred to as fingering or fine, or actually super fine, excuse me. You can see I've already started using some of it to make a shawl, which eventually I will have to block out. But you can see how it's pretty thin, and as the name sock yarn suggests, it's often used to make socks. Especially, you will also often want to have a mix, though, of nylon if you're going to make some socks with this type of yarn. This that I have right here is from, it's a Cascade yarn, it's called Heritage Silk Paints, and it's 85% merino wool and 15% silk, so this would probably not be great for socks just because it's not going to be something that wears that well. Then we move up here, some more fingering or sock yarn, and then here is a little bit thicker. This is called considered fine, and it might be called sport yarn or even baby yarn, and as the name suggests, you would use it for baby items. This works really well for baby hats, blankets, it's usually very soft, and again, still kind of on the thin side, but not quite as thin as sock yarn. Then you get a little bit thicker with DK. DK is considered a light yarn or light worsted, you might hear it called. And this is often used, a lot of people will use this for sweaters. Then we're moving up here to worsted, and this can vary a little bit. I mean, here I have an example of a Knit Picks worsted wool of the Andes, and then Impeccable from Loops and Threads, which is a brand that Michaels has. And to me, the Knit Picks looks quite a bit thinner than the Michaels brand. So then you move up to Aran weight, which again is considered a similar weight to worsted, but this, you can see, again, is to me a teensy bit thicker, not a whole lot, but more so than the Knit Picks. Okay, so they can range a little bit. And then finally we have this bulky here. This is Woolies from Lion Brand, and this is really useful for things like, I like to use it on a loom for knitted hats, great for the round loom and knitted hats. You can whip them up in a couple of hours. Or if you want something like a really thick blanket. And then something I don't have here is super bulky, which that is most often used for something like rugs. And as far as usefulness goes for the worsted, which is the most common weight, it's a medium size weight yarn. It's very useful for things like a blanket, maybe a heavier garment than you might use a DK for, and also works really well if you like to make stuffy toys like I do, amigurumi especially. And so those are the different yarn sizes in a nutshell. There's not any specific gauge. You can find a range of gauges, and they can all alter a little bit depending on the manufacturer.